Montpelier University, and he's going to talk to us about right up there.
Okay. So. Okay, thank you to invite me to share some thoughts, concepts, and tools with you. During the last outbreak on IF Ebola, I was in charge of coordinating the IF Ebola, European IF Ebola project. During this project, because we arrived too late, I mean, the funds arrived in 2015, then we couldn't have access directly to patients. Then we began to work on more on preparedness than real solutions during the outbreak. And then now we are working on another European project, Pandora, which is Pan-African Network for Rapid Research, Response, and Preparedness for Infectious Disease Epidemics. Then I would like to talk about the context where we are all together. Then this is the context. The context is that the human demography growth is out of control. Then we are not in the situation where these guys here, Pasteur and colleagues, were in 18th century, where they have only 1 billion inhabitants during General Pasteur period, with a situation quite different from our situation, where we are living. I take an example here, the palm oil consequences, where we are losing a lot of flora and fauna. Almost all over the world, we lost 50% of that. Then that means with overpopulation and overconsuming, we are creating ecological disaster here. And we have seen here in the last 30 years, less 80% of insects. And in 15 last years, 30% of birds in Europe. This is our data that are very recent. And then in this example of palm oil, you see orangutans, they don't know where to go because they are simply killed. They are losing also elephants, tigers, and rhino, water pollution. Then this is the situation where we are working with our health solutions. Then I think that we need to take what we are doing and try to do something with that. Not only just thinking in molecular biology and solutions, but we need to go over in a holistic way to see the situation that we are living. And then because of the, as you know, all these epidemics are going on all the time. And what we see is that the response are too slow. We see the epidemics come. I mentioned some of them here. Come and go. We are never ready to find solutions. Then this is because we try to make a preparedness project. This was the team of IF Ebola. Then an early Ebola detection for an early post-exposure passive immunotherapy. This was the objective of this project. And then with doing this, we made a sort of toolbox. We succeed to increase the Ebola detection with ultra-sensitive diagnostic that I will show you. We made also an anti-Ebola immunotherapy based upon on one century old technique, doing IgG fragments, FAPs here in horses that were particularly efficient in well-established mouse and guinea pig models. We did this with Ian Feldman and Gary Cominger in Canada and Ian Feldman in the NIH in Montana. both BSL-4 labs, and then we simply succeed to rescue the model of Guinea pig infected animals from the day 3, that means in the middle of the of the experiment, we're providing these fabs. They were all jumping like rabbits after that. In the meantime, they were dying because the experiment, it lasts only 1 week without treatment. All of them died otherwise. Then this way to do is make a collaborative agreement between WHO and Fabentech, which is a company here that made these antibodies in Lyon, and the European Medical Agency have declared this product one of the 5 most promising therapies against Ebola. Also, using our toolbox, we created an accurate metagenomic analysis using a particularly performant algorithm, Rigel, and along with a new data bank, which is 22 times higher than the existing gene bank, to assess the Ebola strain variations and co-infections. And the last but not the least, we added something that is very important to provide in treatment centers, is plasma water sanitation system, which is a system to provide clean water for hydration and hygiene or for healthcare and patients in those centers. That is what we did. This is the way how to do this whole technique to make antibodies and in a GMP way, make the stockpiling and then go to humans. This is the NGS and metagenomic analysis that we did. We found with this approach that from the data that we got from Sierra Leone, 80% of those were Lassa infected. And this is the system of water. Then you have here dirty water that become plasma converted, and then you get clean water that you can drink. And this is to replace the system that are already used in Africa to get water in plastic gallons. Then now go to the center of my talk here is based up on sample prep, based on lipoprotein H, which is this protein, very, very small, highly concentrated in human plasma, and with different structures that allow this protein to interact with virus, bacteria, fungi, and parasite, and even prions. Then this protein is selective in a certain way because it will detect only pathogenic bacteria and not commensal bacteria. Then it will catch with high affinity here, or about nanomolar affinity, those pathogens, whatever be the virus, enveloped, non-enveloped, RNA, DNA. And then we used that to show using nanomagnetic beads that were used to catch the virus in a preparation. These nanomagnetic beads are coated with the protein, ApoH lipoprotein. And then you can see when we do spiking of H3N2 flu virus. And then you can see when we dilute the preparations, we can see without ApoH, we cannot detect anymore at the last dilutions. Then you can see that here we are getting 100, two logs gain. I will show you how it works. Then we put this bead with coated with ApoH, we shake it. Then we apply a magnet, and then we clean up, and then this from these precipitated beads with pathogens, we are able to do PCR, put them in culture, or any other system of detection. Then we can isolate viruses or bacteria. Alternatively, we can make an illusion of that. And here, I can show you some results also with this time with Ebola, infectious Ebola VLP, done in Marburg Institute in Germany. This is in plasma, the same. Then we gain two logs in sensitivity. And here we show that the protein captured by ApoH is the GP, the envelope of Ebola here, with a very nice curve. And here there are some samples from Sierra Leone, when you can see without ApoH here and with ApoH, then you can gain almost two logs again in clinical samples. And then I move to dengue, because this today is arbovirus. Then I will explain you this table that was done with Fiocruz and Curitiba lab and the Rio de Janeiro from the hospital in Rio de Janeiro, managed by Fiocruz. They give us only negative samples, NS1 and RT-PCR without ApoH. All those were negative. As soon as we add the process of sample preparation with ApoH, at the first the sample from the first visit corresponding to those negative, most of them become immediately positive. And then, like this way, we solved more than 70% of dengue false negative diagnosis. After that, the Ministry of Health in Brazil asked for IgM, maybe our colleague from Brazil will tell me how do they do that, because it was supposed that they do PCR, but they told me that they do only IgM. And then doing this, we confirmed that our positive effectively were positive with ApoH, but at the early stage. Here the same for, you know, HCV, without ApoH and with ApoH, you can see. And then by this way, we solved 44% of false negatives done with COVAS at the hospital in Grenoble in France. Then you can see that ApoH plus quantitative PCR COVAS is the result will be the same for high viral loads. In contrast, it will be more important. We will solve false negative ApoH and PCR more importantly than COVAS does for the low viral loads. This is antiviruses that are isolated this time with the thanks to the beads here. This is the control in green. And without virus, you can see the control negative. Then we can use this approach to isolate virus, whatever be the kind of virus, H3N2, for example, here, without ApoH. And with ApoH, we can catch much more, and that they keep their pathogenic function. Also, and very importantly, we did some water analysis, and where we found, thanks to NGS and metagenomic analysis done with this particular algorithm and metagenomic analysis, you can see with ApoH you have a lot of reads, 1 million reads, as compared with the same sample without ApoH. You have very few reads. Then it will increase also those analysis of metagenomic. Here we discovered that dengue was the virus that was responsible of this unexplained encephalitis in Manaus. And here we can see also the other one was Neisseria meningitidis that was responsible of this unexplained encephalitis. Then you can see that this is this system will increase many logs, and very importantly the detection of of viruses, whatever be the kind of virus, which is very important for early detection and late detection. Early detection, for example, for Ebola, is very important because you can have a very good contact tracing from one side, and the late detection for residual viral loads in those convalescent or survivors individuals. And then just to finalize with bacteria, you know that sepsis is very urgent, has urgent needs in a way to do the diagnostic as soon as it is possible, because otherwise the infection gain and the patient could die after 6 hours. This is the, and then this is the clinical sensitivity, the normal way to do, day one, day two, sometimes day four. This is the normal way to do without ApoH. When you use the system of ApoH, you can detect one, say a few, or one bacteria per 5 mL of whole blood. And this can be done in less than 4 hours. You can see here one say a few on 5 mL of whole blood. This was also approved by Siemens Healthcare Company. And this is just, it's not exhaustive table of what we have tried in like bacteria. Some of those that were not easily cultivable, like Trophirema we play here. Okay, these are the results with this ultrasensitive technology. But the most important, I think, that the present and future of our planet context of our health intervention made in is made in a very rapid changing world. Then our input must be to try to have a real One Health meta approach that implies to urgently consider the planet health, not only the human health, the whole thing, because it's like it's our living milieu. Like for good cells, we can have a very resistant cells in a bad milieu, and then we are going to lose every cell. And here is the same for us. We need to consider this reality. Consequently, we need action with impact purpose. This is because we propose this toolbox for health and education to try to control the demography because of waste and many things that I mentioned before. And then I think that the better way is to educate young women in a way that they could become stronger to impact the planning, familial planning. This was very rapid, sorry for the rapidity of that, but I think that we have techniques, we can improve, we have vaccines, we have many things, but we need to consider the situation that we are living right now, that is was very different that in relation to what this guy knew at that time. That's all.